Hi everyone, Phil from Tech for Techs here. Today we're going to be looking at this from Be Quiet. It's their Lightwings 120mm PWM high speed fan kit, which obviously includes three fans. We're going to give it a run in and see exactly how it performs. And if you're interested in purchasing this, we've got links in the description below. If you click on those, you'll also get the latest prices online. Are you looking for a great networking solution? Well, Tender has it all. Finding your BT router no longer has the power? Then try one of these from Tender.
Hell yeah!
Is the Wi-Fi on your laptop not working and you need a discreet solution? Well, then get this from Tender.
Hell yeah!
Finding the kids can't get Wi-Fi in the bedroom and they're making your life miserable? Well, you need to get one of these from Tender.
Oh, hell yeah!
Looking for a low-cost solution to get internet into your home office? Then you need to get some of these from Tender.
Hell yeah!
For all your networking needs, trust Tender.
Hell yeah!
Okay, so we've got the Be Quiet Lightwings 120mm PWM high speed. PWM basically means it's a 4-pin connector what connects to your fan socket on your motherboard, which basically allows it to adjust the speed of the fans. As you can see, they're all RGB, and to show what the RGB looks like, they've got sort of a ring around the actual fan. But not only that, on the back of the box, it shows you a ring going around the back of the fan as well, so it looks like you've got the effects on both sides, so you can see the effect from whatever angle you look at the fan from inside the case. On the side of the box, you've got specifications down here if you do want a bit more information, and on this side you've just got a QR code. Okay, these are specifications from the manufacturer and some oomph about them. So basically, the Lightwing fans are the first Be Quiet fans with ARGB lighting and offer impressive illumination combined with vibrant, unique look, strong performance and quiet operation with efficient cooling. The ARGB lighting is on the front and the rear of the fans, so you can basically see it from whichever angle you look at near enough, and up to 20 individual addressable LEDs per fan. Effects can be synchronized with ARGB compatible motherboard, rifle bearing with up to 60,000 hours runtime. There's 120mm as well as 140mm variants available, which are all PWM, which basically means it's a 4-pin connector, as single or triple pack, so you can buy them individually or as a 3-pack. The 3-packs do come with an ARGB hub for synchronization of up to 6 ARGB components, and the ARGB signal can be daisy chained as well. Prices, best thing to do is click the links in the description below, because prices are up and down at the moment and we've got these pre-released and they're not 100% set. Okay, so this is what you've got inside the box. We've got three fans what come in three separate boxes there, as well as another box which all these other bits came in. So we've got a manual here which basically tells you how it all works and everything like that and how to put it all together. You've also got a bit of information about disposing electrical items and so forth, which I'm not sure if they're necessary these days with that. I don't see this in most products anymore. Usually you access the manual and that information via a QR code. It saves environment, then they can update it and everything like that. Saves you money, saves them money and so forth. Next you've got, it's not actually a controller, it's more of a hub or a splitter is probably the best way of putting it. So you basically plug it this hub into a SATA connection, and then it allows you to connect this cable to your motherboard via the hub itself, which allows you then to add up to 6 devices via one connection. Then you've got 4 lots of screws here, 3 for the actual fans itself, and then 1 for this. We'll go into what those ones are in a few seconds. And then you've also got this double-sided sticker here, so you can stick your controller onto something if you wish. Okay, so let's take a look at the fan. So as you can see here, you've got the fan, it's got 9 blades, it's got sort of like a ripple effect on each of the blades, which is pretty good. You've got that white circle going around, that's going to be for your RGB lighting on this side. And you've also got four screw holes, which do feel like the rubberized. It feels like a very good build quality. They're definitely not cheap, that's for sure. On the other side, obviously, you've got the manufacturer's information there as well. And you've also got an RGB ring here. You can just about make it out there, 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 and there. When I say a ring, there is a slight cutout where the actual frame obviously goes to the motor, but it does generally go near enough all the way around, other than a few little gaps. The cabling on here is 50 centimeters long, but this is where I'm a little bit confused, because on the RGB cable, you've got a splitter, so you can daisy chain it. So you could, in theory, daisy chain all three fans, which means then you'll have one connection you'd plug in your board. So why would you need a hub? Okay, it allows you to add extra fans on top if you wanted to, but you can actually run three fans, no problem, off of one RGB header via daisy chaining. So it seems a little bit strange, but the biggest issue I've got is, obviously, the PWM fans, yeah, brilliant. You've got four pins connect up. But you've got three fans, you've got three headers. There is no splitter, no way to daisy chain them or combine them. A lot of motherboards don't have three headers, three to add fans. A lot only have one or two on top of the usual one what you have for your CPU fan. So unless you've got a real high-end board, which has got three available sockets, you're not going to be able to connect all your fans without having to go out and purchase a splitter or a combiner cable for your fans. So I'm very disappointed with that, especially with spending the sort of price we are on this unit. They should include some way of being able to daisy chain or combine these cables into one. So not very good. And in all reality, this hub is, I'm not sure it's needed in all honesty, unless you are combining even more RGB devices, then it gives you the ability, but you don't actually need it to run these three fans. Okay, so we've got the hub, and again, it is a hub, not a controller. It does have a power connection to give it a little bit more power, so if you are connecting up to six items on here, you can actually do so. That's not a problem, but it doesn't really power the RGB effects or anything like that. It isn't a controller, it's just basically a hub, just like you would get a USB hub, which extends from one hub and creates more. And that's all it is. It does have a connection on the end there where you can connect it via a cable, or you have to connect it via cable to your motherboard. So that's there. And then you've got those three connections on either side to add in our ARGB devices. Again, it's ARGB only, so that's addressable RGB. Some people call it digital and so forth. One nice thing about it is it's got four screw holes on the bottom there. That will actually measure up with a solid state drive bay, so 2.5 inch drive. So a lot of cases have, usually these days, on the back of them, they have places where you can screw in a 2.5 inch solid state drive, usually vertical, horizontal, depending on how it's designed. But you can actually screw it in just as if it was a 2.5 inch SSD, which is good. If you don't have room to do that, you have got the sticky, double-sided sticky tape or whatever it is over there, which you can stick on the back and then stick it onto something inside the case. Again, this is not a controller. There's no way to change the lighting from here. There's no buttons on it. There's no remote or anything like that, which is slightly disappointing. Okay, so we've got the three fans set up. We've got it quite dark in here so you can actually see what they look like. Again, pictures on the camera aren't always best when they're really bright lights, so we'll do some B-roll, hopefully capture what they actually look like. So I'm just turning the machine on now, just to give you a rough idea. The fans are coming on, and there goes the RGB effect. It's on a rainbow effect at the moment, spinning round. So they do look pretty nice. Obviously, when you've got it in a dark case, it's going to shine very well. Obviously, in bright light, so for example, when we've got studio lights on, you can't see it that well, which, to be honest, is normal with most RGB things anyway, due to the light picking up on the diffusers what are around them. So the fans itself, they seem to do everything they should do. You can change the effects on there, so you can have different colours, different styles and stuff, just to give you a rough idea. But these effects are down to your motherboard or the controller that you're going to use. It's nothing to do with that hub what's included. That hub, to be honest with you, is pretty much a waste of time unless you're wanting to add more RGB devices to it. We've got it hooked up directly to the motherboard using the daisy chains at the moment with no problem. So it gives you a rough idea is why is the hub in there in the first place. It's a good question, especially for the price. I would have thought it would have been a full functioning controller. For example, for around £45, you can pick up an Aerocool free fan pack, which is all RGB, very similar, but with sort of an infinity mirror on it. It comes with the controller as well. And on top of that, it also comes with a remote control, so you can change the lighting effects. You don't get any of that with this. Really, you're just getting three fans and a box, so you can add on more fans if you did want to in the future. The problem, or the biggest problem I see, is that there's no way to combine the cables onto for the actual fan speed, or the fan power, or whatever you want to do it. The PWM, there's only, well, there's no combiner cable. You have to plug them directly, each one, into your motherboard. So that's three spare headers you need on your motherboard to plug those in without having to buy something separate. That should have been included in the box as a minimum, rather than the hub, what they've got. There should be a combiner cable in there for the PWM fan speed. It's just a... I don't know how they didn't put one in, to be honest with you. It seems a little bit stupid to me. The motherboard we're using is a roughly a £350 motherboard, and it only had three headers on there for fans extra on top of the one what comes for the actual main CPU. So that gives you a rough idea. So unless you've got a real top-end board, you're going to struggle connecting all those up without having to spend extra. And you've spent a lot of money on these. These aren't the cheapest RGB kits I've seen. Don't get me wrong, they look nice. And if you turn them around, so excuse me while they're on, you've also got the effect on the back as well, which looked pretty good. But as I said, you are paying extra. You don't get the controller. You don't get a remote. In reality, even though it says it comes with a hub, you're really just getting free fans. So testing. So we tested the fans on these and found they performed extremely well, which is good considering the RGB, because RGB fans generally perform worse than non-RGB fans. And the reason being, and a lot of people don't realise this, is because the RGB has been added to the fan, so you've got this big ring around the edge, it obviously makes the blades smaller on the fan. And because the blades are smaller, that generally means either they don't perform as well, or the fan has to spin faster, which means it makes more noise. And in this case, they actually didn't sound loud at all. They were very quiet under normal operations, just as quiet as any other performance fan you would find on the market. So they were very, very quiet, while the airflow was still very good. So I'd say it was, in comparison to most of them out there, for example, the Arctic P12 and F12 range, the very similar sort of performance you were getting out of the box. And then obviously you've got the RGB effects on there, which were giving you some really good light effects. Don't get me wrong, doesn't look like a disco ball or anything along that lines, but it gives you a nice subtle lighting which you can see from all around. So if you're sitting sort of a sideways to the actual fan, you can see the light. And if you're sitting behind it, you can see the light. And if you're in front of it, again, you can see the light. And so you can see lighting from whatever angle you want. So in conclusion, would we recommend these? Well, it's hard to say, really. I think an individual fan on its own, yeah, I'd recommend it. If it was a free pack, I would recommend it. But for some reason, they include a hub. And this hub pretty much doesn't really do much. In most cases, if you go out and buy a free pack of RGB fans, you get an RGB controller. This doesn't come with that. So the hub, all it does is allows you to add more fans on the actual hub so you can connect them all together, which is good. It gives you options to add more RGB devices together. So, yeah, that sounds good. But why didn't they do that for the PWM controller or the actual fan cable what you use to power the fan? There's no splitter included in the box, which, okay, might be a minor thing. They're not very expensive, but when you go out and buy a product, especially this sort of price, you expect it to have everything you need in the box, which it doesn't. And that's my biggest issue with this, is the cheapest item, what they could have added in there to make it easy for people, is the bit they didn't add in. And then obviously the issue with the RGB, I would have made that an RGB controller, would have preferred to pay an extra £5-10 for the pack to have a proper controller in there with a mini remote so you could change the lights if you hadn't got RGB on your motherboard. Because not everyone has got RGB on the motherboard. A lot of people out there will go out and buy these lights to add into older machines which don't have ARGB connections or even standard RGB connections in some cases. So they require a proper hub. But don't get me wrong, you can go out and buy a special one separately from someone else and so forth, but I think it really needed to be in the free pack, even if it cost a little bit more. If you're just looking at the fans for performance and look wise, yeah, they look very good, they perform very well. Just make sure though you have got enough fan sockets on your motherboard to basically support them. But otherwise, yeah, they're very, very good, but just let down by those niggly issues, as I said, with the RGB and the connections. They perform exactly how I'd expect from a Be Quiet product, but they're just missing something, and that something is that controller and proper cabling connections so you can connect it up to your motherboard. Thank you for watching this video, everyone. It's really appreciated you made it all the way to the end. Please make sure you subscribe, like, comment, and even click that bell so you get notifications of new videos and live streams. It does help support the channel, and supporting the channel basically means that we can release more content for you and also better quality content going forward. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you next time.